In this video, we are going to talk about the recent Yoast price increase. So we're going to talk about some other SEO plugin alternatives. And we're also going to talk about website copy and the single question that you need to answer for your website visitors. Hi, my name is Adam from WPCrafter.com, where I make WordPress tutorial videos for non-techies. If you're new here, consider clicking on that subscribe button. If you don't want to miss a thing, click on the bell. YouTube will let you know when I have a new video. This is actually my weekly wrap-up show. I didn't do it last week. I try to do this every week where I wrap up the week and some of the things going on here with WP Crafter, talk about some current stories, and also try to get into some other meat and potatoes. So welcome to this video episode. And so first of all, I want to just give you a couple updates on WP Crafter. Now, when I'm referring to that, that's the channel and the community and the Facebook group. Just a few updates on what's going on here. Number one, I wanted to update you on the community guideline strike that I got on YouTube. So I'm not going to be able to beat this thing. So for a period of time until June 3rd, I won't be able to do any live streaming. That's okay. I'm going to roll with it. YouTube, I appealed. YouTube said that there was some thing that they think I violated and they wouldn't listen to reason. And so that's okay. Sometimes you just have to roll with it. And I finally got a response on that, which is good. So I can't wait to go live again so there can be questions and answering and all that kind of stuff. So now we're just going to roll with it the way it is. June 3rd is the date I should get that back. This week I had a variety of videos. Next week I'm going to try to focus on all of the advanced Elementor Pro features. So the focus of the week will be covering all the new features that came out with Elementor Pro version 2. I'll have other video content as well. This is what came out this week, the five videos. On Monday, I had a video about the GDPR, and that's something we all have to really take serious and start paying attention to, especially since it goes into effect next month on the 25th. The GDPR, that's a great video to go over. I'll have a follow-up video. This week, there was two videos about AppSumo deals. You could check those out, SERPstat and 24 Sessions. And I had a video about Beaver Builder. Now, I have said that the reason I don't make as many videos about Beaver Builder is because they don't really get watched that much. This is a perfect example right here, Beaver Builder video, and it got not even 1,000 views on it, which is actually kind of low. Usually if this was about Elementor, it would be at 4 or 5,000 views right now, about 4 or 5 times more views. It is what it is. That's okay. And also with this, it did get some promotion from Beaver Builder itself, and it's still, it's just not getting much traction. But that's okay, because I'm still going to make videos on Beaver Builder. But that's what I had there. So that's just some of the updates going on right here. I did want to take a moment to read some of the funny comments that, or maybe funny or offensive comments that I received this week on the channel. So this is a comment right here from Chris. If you leave a funny comment, it just might end up in this video. And Chris says, in this one video I made about how to make a pop-up for Beaver Builder, he says, "Thank you, Vars." And I said, "It's usually that or Dr. Evil." If you don't know who Vars is, it's a character in Game of Thrones. As a matter of fact, I never even thought that there was a resemblance between me and Vars. However, one day, I think it was Sujay from Brainstorm Force, they make the Astra theme and all that kind of stuff. He had sent me a picture that was going around in their office about me looking like Vars. And that's when I first realized, hey, I probably do look like Vars. So it's either Vars or Dr. Evil. I got this one today. I'm going to click on it. I don't want to offend anyone, so it might be a little risque. Hopefully I don't offend you. So I got this from someone. A lot of times people, they pop on the channel and they pop off. They're not going to be here on a regular basis. And this person said to me, and I don't mean this to offend anyone, said, "I like your tutorial, but you should definitely work on your voice. It sounds very gay. No offense, but it makes it not easy to stay focused." August. I don't even know what to do with this comment. This is a comment that I will delete. I probably actually have already deleted it. And you know what? My voice is my voice. I can't really change it. A funny thing about my voice, though. And so, and I understand this, whenever I have had to pick up the phone and call a business, like maybe a credit card or a public utility, or pick up the phone, call a restaurant or something like that, for some reason, they've always thought, the way my voice sounds on the phone, that I'm a woman. They'll say, yes, ma'am, and that's how I know. It's just a funny, funny thing, so it's good if I ever need to call anything on my wife's behalf. I just say I'm her, and no one even questions it. Anyways, I do delete comments, just so you know, on the channel. So if there's vile or offensive, and they come regularly, I just delete it. There's no sense in leaving anything like that on there. And if you haven't noticed, my comments are moderated. You can criticize me, and that's okay. I'll leave that and answer that. But then once there's vulgarity and all kinds of stuff like that in, I will go ahead and cut that out. Okay, so next I wanted to talk about Yoast. Yoast makes an SEO plugin, and most of us know it as it's just free, but they also have a paid version of that plugin that has some additional features. Now, Yoast recently increased the price significantly, and according to there's actually a big discussion about this going on in the WP Crafter Facebook group, and here's an article about it as well, talking about how the price increase equates to about 240%, which is pretty massive, and I actually think that it's too expensive. I do. I mean, if you're using it and you're getting value and you just had a single license, you're not going to feel it as much. But if you had multiple licenses, that's where it's really going to hurt. They used to have a discount if you purchased a license for multiple websites. They don't have an unlimited license version. And so those discounts, it was like a stacking discount. So if you had it for 5 sites, it'd be a bigger discount. And they kind of removed that, and that's where most of the price increase is coming from. And a lot of upset users reached out to Yoast and said, I don't get it. This is just so not right. It's such a drastic price increase. It's not 10%, 20%. It's much more than that. And essentially, Yoast got back to all those people with probably the same canned answer that, you know, we've added a lot of features and stuff like that. And that's why, and we did these other things, and that's why you should pay this higher price. You know what? I'll tell you, I don't think Yoast Premium is worth it if you have more than one website. That being said, I do use Yoast Premium on my website, WP Crafter. I am using Yoast Premium, but this is a pretty dramatic price increase if you ask me. And I hope it's not a sign of things to come. I do think this price increase is so dramatic that they might feel it. They might definitely feel it in renewals. And the good news is there's a lot of alternatives. Now, let me tell you, the only reason I use the paid version of Yoast is because I like the redirect feature. Now you can get that in a free plugin where if I delete a page, it'll automatically set up my redirect. I like that. The second thing I like, and I don't know of an alternative that has this, it scans your content of your blog posts. So if you're writing a new blog post or content anywhere on your blog, it'll suggest these other articles on your website. So it makes it easy to have interlinking content, which is very important with SEO. It has that feature. I really like that feature a lot. I don't know if it's, I use it enough to make it worth the higher renewal cost, but there's lots of alternatives. There's the free Yoast plugin. I think most people don't even upgrade to premium. They just have the free one. There's the SEO framework, which is a much leaner SEO plugin. There's SEO Press. The developer actually on this reached out to me, and I sent him an email back, and I never heard back from him. I might have offended him unintentionally in my email. I basically said, you should change your logo. It doesn't look professional, and you should change a couple things. It doesn't look that great. But It's a good value. It's only $39 and you get unlimited sites and it's that per year. I think he'll probably increase the price, but when you go to his website, it doesn't look like a serious plugin to me. I think there's a lot of things that he could do to just make it visually look better. So there's lots of alternatives to Yoast, thank goodness. And the reality is you don't need to necessarily be so married to an SEO plugin because it's very easy to switch. All of them pretty much have migrators built in. So for Yoast, if you're using something else and you want to start using Yoast, they have a migrator where it will take the data out of the other one and put it into Yoast. And all of the other ones have the same type of migration. So it's easy to move from one SEO plugin to another SEO plugin. But really, for what most people use these SEO plugins for, it's really basic and you could probably, I would think, get the same exact value in a leaner package out of the SEO framework. And then if you wanted some more advanced stuff, if you were someone that was going to pay for an SEO plugin, you might want to take a look at SEO Press. Also, for you web developers developing websites for other people, I think there's also a white label built into SEO Press. So that's a nice feature. A lot of people tend to like that. So that's it for the news. And I wanted to talk about something that I've been thinking a lot about. And I think this applies to anyone that has a website. I've been working on some sales pages for my website for the training courses so I can actually start properly selling them. And one of the things that I realized is the most important aspect of any website. That means there's the ones it doesn't apply to. Say you have a blog and you're just putting up pictures of your trip to Iceland or to the zoo, and it's just for your friends, family, and followers. Not so much those types of websites, but the real practical websites, the ones that you're building, my website, the most important thing that needs to be communicated right when someone gets onto your webpage is very simple. What problem do you solve? That is the single most important question that needs to get answered. And I probably need to do a better job of doing that here on this website of mine. But I want to challenge you to spend some time to really think about what problem are you solving for people? People buy solutions. How can you identify the problem that you solve for them and then communicate it to them? And there's a lot that might go into it, but it's definitely something that I want to challenge you to think about, you know, when you have those free moments, just to be thinking about what is the problem that you solve and how to put that into words that someone can quickly understand and connect with. And part of that is understanding who your customer is to begin with, or who your website visitor is to begin with, or who you want to be your customer or client. Identifying who those people are and then figure out the problem that you want to solve for them. And that's what your website should communicate instantaneously when someone lands on it. And this applies to every single website. And once you understand that, then your next question or your next need is how can I make more money through my website? And the answer is actually very simple. Just solve bigger problems. And so when you think about your business, your website in that framework, it's going to make it a whole lot easier for you to effectively communicate to your potential clients, your potential customers, or the people that are on your website, what the website's about, what they're there for, what you are prepared and ready to do for them. What problem are you going to solve? So, you know, we think that we know what someone's problem is, but sometimes we really don't. So say you're a website designer, developer, and someone comes to you. You think that they're coming to you because they want a website, and that's the problem. But that's not the problem. And if you do a little bit of digging to find out what is the problem that is bringing them to actually want the website in the first place, that's when you can make a greater connection with them and have a solution to what their problem is. Wanting a website is not a solution to the problem. It's maybe they need to have more business coming in and they think a website's going to get them that. Or maybe they're trying to compete. There's some competitors that have some nice websites and they want to compete. They want to look really good. Maybe that's the problem they have. Just dig a little deeper into their business, their potential customer's business, and why they say they want what they want, to identify what they see as the problem. And then solve that problem for them. Offer them a solution. That's how you sell. That's how you use your website as an effective selling tool. So I don't want to beat this as a dead... Oh, actually, I can't say that because animal rights people get mad at me sometimes. I love animals, but sometimes I might make a reference to maybe beating a dead horse, and that's a figure of speech of, you know, I don't need to continue talking about this point. It's already been made. Anyways, I want to challenge you with that. What is the problem you're trying to solve with your website, or is the problem you're trying to solve that you need to communicate to people that come to your website? And I'd like you to work on that, think about that, and in the comment section down below, write out in one or two sentences the problem that you are trying to solve for the people that come to your website. I know the problem I'm trying to solve. I'm trying to help people understand something that it could be seen as technical, and I'm trying to explain it in a way that anyone can understand. It's WordPress for non-techies. It's just, what, 3 or 4 words right there. And I think it gets the point across very quickly. However, I do think I can do things better. So I just want to challenge you with that, thinking about what problems do you actually solve? How can you put that into words and make that be the first thing someone sees at the top of your website? And let me know about it in the comments section down below. Have a great weekend. I will see you in the next video.